السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Whenever you are, wherever you are, today lesson is about how to go to the toilet and to speed up to go to the toilet or to race to go to the toilet. We were visiting West Africa in April, May 2007, and this was my last journey field visit to with Islamic Relief Worldwide before leaving it in April 2008. And our delegation was between 15 and 16 international staff from headquarters, from Britain, from USA, from Switzerland, from France, from Germany, and from Holland. Amongst us were three young girls, one from America and two from Britain. One of them were not Muslim and it was her first time to travel to a field office. Her name was Helen. We were supposed to visit the following places. First of all, Libya, Tripoli, because we have used the Libyan airline or the African airline. And this was a long transit for up to 12 hours. And we had to come out of the airport to go and visit the Gaddafi Foundation and to pray Jum'ah and to have lunch with the executives of the Gaddafi Foundation at the time. Second visit was supposed to go to Chad to inaugurate or to open the Office of Islamic Relief in N'Djamena. Then to go and visit the refugees camp at the border between Chad and Sudan, the Darfurian refugees camps. Third stop was going to Islamic Relief office in Niger to visit the local projects which had been organized and implemented by Islamic Relief. Fourth visit was go to the office of Islamic Relief in Mali and then to go to Tombuktu, then from Tombuktu to go to Gourma Rarous in the middle of the desert. And this was a very heavy program. And the amount of work daily was between 18 to 20 hours every day. What were we doing? In the early morning, go to the field visit, start taking photographs and making story with the beneficiary or the poor people, visiting the officials, writing the case studies for young women and children and others, then exchanging the information, reports and photographs and video between everyone at the time of dinner between 9 and 10. So all this used to happen after we have the dinner at 9 or 10 in the evening. So we used to end our day after midnight, every day. So the first journey was in Chad, in N'Djamena, and we were put in four-star hotel. We were very and extremely upset and wanted to change the hotel, but we failed. So we decided in Niger to change that. In Niger, we stayed in guest house and not in a hotel like that to cut down the expenses. In Mali, we had a community center. And the idea came to us, instead of going to hotel, we canceled the hotel booking and we bought some mattresses and some blankets and we were sleeping in the empty rooms inside the community center to cut down more cost in this area. Then we started the program in Mali and we've been traveling for hours and hours and hours to visit one of the countryside places, small town. And I was in the car and I was stuck. I want to go to the toilet. Soon we arrived. I rushed before everybody to go to the toilet, to be the first, because I was a little bit scared of what will happen if I'm late. Why to be the first? Because I was anticipating there could not be no water in the toilet. There's no clean plastic container to clean yourself up. Even if I go later, it might have a very bad smell and the toilet itself will be filled with whatever you call it. And number four, it could be impossible to use the seat of the toilet later on after it's been used by quite a few people. Then I benefited from being the president, abusing my authority to be the first to use the toilet before anybody else. Because they didn't want to suffer. Lesson learned. It's not right that somebody like myself to be the first and compete to go to the toilet first. In spite of the fact, it could be my right, but wrong. I have competed and I run and I rushed before anybody else. And this is wrong, this is wrong, this is wrong. Kullukum ra'i. You are the ra'i. You are the custodian. You are the caretaker of those people. And you are responsible for them. So you should not be ahead of them in this. But if I have an excuse because of a medical problem, because of age, I have to take a permission from them, whether they granted this permission to me or not. And this is why I'm talking about this kind of behavior, which should not be right by anybody, even if he or she is the president or the chief of staff of the organization. Thank you very much for listening to me. I see you another lesson, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.